The MIT Museum is MIT's window on the world, and it's also the world's window on MIT. Our job in the museum is to make research and innovation as available and accessible to ordinary folks as we possibly can.
We're trying to test something that Albert Einstein had called spooky actions at a distance. We're testing, does the world of the very small, the world of atoms and parts of atoms, obey something called quantum entanglement?
We're always interested in the museum in current research at MIT. This particular piece of research intrigued me because it deals with some of the most basic ideas in physics, which are in turn some of the most basic ideas we have about the way the universe works.
We were very, very lucky to get support for the experiment, the series of experiments, from the U.S. National Science Foundation. The NSF always puts a high premium on what they call public outreach or public engagement.
There are a lot of questions being asked in the United States today about what's the point of science, and particularly what's the point of basic research, research asking really fundamental questions. And this is a very good example of that. So this is research which is really probing some of the most basic features of the world we live in.
Right from the beginning, my colleagues and I started to brainstorm what we might be able to do with this topic within our museum.
The project we've conceived is very, if you like, multimedia. We have some exhibition components. We've got some displays being built in the museum. We also have programs, we have some seminars and some educational programs, but alongside that, maybe some drama might also help here.
We have a unique and created just for this project, one-act play that was developed by the Central Square Theater as part of the Catalyst Collaborative at MIT.
I had never even heard of quantum entanglement before, and it was just mind-boggling. And of course, the idea, like, you're gonna write a 20-minute play about this thing that's really hard to visualize, we can't really draw a picture of it. That was a really big challenge, and I like challenges. I like challenges a lot.
The play will run in the museum on many occasions, so museum visitors can come and experience it, and before or after, of course, explore the exhibit with the student-made components.
So this exhibition is a pretty concise installation of the concept, where we have MIT students who are physicists and mathematicians coming in to actually think about the subject matter and how to represent it visually.
Here in the museum, we love to work with MIT students, undergraduates and grad students. We think that they get a lot out of learning how to communicate about science, and we get a lot from their energy, their enthusiasm, and their smarts, really.
Our project is called Spooky Action, and it is a way for people to experience quantum entanglement, specifically a process whereby two particles can actually influence each other's behaviors despite being physically separated.
And so we try to visualize that effect by using a strobe light to highlight certain positions of the rotating ball. And so the ball's rotating at a constant rate, it's always continuously moving, but the strobe effect makes it look like it's frozen in space.
There are multiple ways that museum visitors can explore this concept through the performance, through the exhibit, and through the very many public programs that we're running in conjunction with the entire topic itself. I think we, you know, enjoy the challenge of coming up with new ways of connecting with audiences. We try to create an engaging setting, maybe a non-traditional setting, where folks might feel welcome.
If we can excite even a couple of adults or children to want to take that deeper dive, that really was the overarching goal here that gave us the freedom to try these other modalities and mediums and how we communicated this topic.
And the MIT Museum wants to be an experimenter. It wants to find new ways of taking science to new audiences. And I think this is going to take a step further forward.
To really say, let's wrestle with these hard concepts and not shy away from them. Is it, what can we do just to try to help people get their hands around this kind of complicated thing?
I think if you wrap all those together, you have a really amazing experience for an audience. And say, wow, this is wondrous. And if we can inspire a sense of wonder, I think that's really exciting.